very hygienic lady. Self-hygiene.
Is that not...
Oh, excuse me. Just a second.
Thank you. Well, this is our house.
It's okay, ma. Given the recent COVID outbreak, can never be too careful.
Mm. This is 2023.
We don't need the spray too now.
My love, it's okay. Yeah. Mm.
Okay.
Mm. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
So good. Every day you dazzle us.
Yes, this one is very clean.
Dazzle us.
OCD.
Yes.
Like
you can never be too careful.
Careful,
yes.
Exactly.
Yes. Please, introduce yourself.
Oh, I'm so sorry. My name is Francesca Akanegu. Mm. Dr. Francesca Akanegu. MD.
D-D-D.
MMSC. MMBC. And soon to be a PhD holder in maternity and child health from the John Hopkins Hospital University.
John Hopkins!
Hey, I have interest in your case.
Wow. This is an honor.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you so much.
Jackpot. I'm going to hit jackpot.
Third class, Lonnie.
No.
No. Oh. He had the third class.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So this is so
important. Yes. Wow. I don't understand you, but that's what
I'm so, so sorry.
Yes, yes.
But we'll teach you one time.
I will be thrilled. I'm
doing my first class. We can use it together.
We are clearly.
So it's like an upgrade for me.
This is very huge upgrade.
Yes.
Ah, lovely to meet you.
You're so pleased too, my dear.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
How did you meet our son?
Well, it's such a fascinating story. But first off, I am fascinated by the gestational conception of your son.
Gestational
conception. Basically, I'm really interested and fascinated on how you gave birth to this Homo sapien of a soul. Yes, yes.
Everybody. So people are really fascinated.
You understand? Bashibimo. Please come down to our level.
She's so brilliant.
She's OND. I had a BS.
Oh, right.
But she's not.
I'm
communicating.
I wanted to know. So your son gave me a little history about his conception.
Yeah.
But you know, when the fascination with your oocytes coming into her vacuum and coming together, combining and resulting in an embryo of an offspring is mind-blowing scientifically. And I want to hear from both of you. How exactly did this come about?
We are sorrow.
They are wild. They are wild.
Basically, yes. Basically, I just want to know, how did you come up with the idea to give birth to this beautiful boy?
So, it's a long story, but I'll keep it brief.
Okay.
We were married to the same
woman. I'm sorry.
Yes.
Doctor. I'm so sorry. Please proceed.
We were married to the same man. And we had fertility issues. I had issues, she had issues, our husband as well. So when we did our medical diagnosis, they found out that she had eggs, but no womb. I had no eggs, but I had a functional womb. So she carried, they took out her egg and, you know, they do that thing.
Art.
Yes.
Yes.
No, it's not art. No, it's science.
I'm so sorry. It's called associative reproductive technology. That's what we scientists call it. Okay, you might know it as IVF.
Yes.
Exactly. I gave her my head.
Yes.
Don't worry.
So it was her egg. It was her eggs that was injected into me. And I had the baby.
So I gave birth to him.
I gave birth. I went through the labor.
But it was my egg.
The baby came out of me.
But they gave you my egg.
But the minimum B now. What is this?
Mommy, this story never ends well. Mommy, you are the mommies.
Okay.
They must fight after they tell you this story. That's the problem.
There is no problem. I gave her my egg.
And I carried the baby for 9 months. 9 months, 12 days.
Are you playing?
Because Pope Pepe told
you me.
I had 48 hours labor for this boy. What did you do? Only egg.
Only egg.
Only egg.
Okay, if I didn't give you the egg, will you be able to
Mommy, carry can we focus on the subject of the day? Can
doctor,
we just focus on the subject
doctor,
of the day?
Doctor, don't worry. Because this situation, we need to know. Okay. But no problem. I'm so
sorry. All I know is that I gave her my egg. And without my egg, she cannot born.
Let me leave this egg alone.
And without my womb, you could not have had a baby.
Why would give another person egg?
Who will carry your egg for you? Who will carry your egg for you?
It's okay. Don't worry.
I'm
sorry.
Doctor,
sorry.
No problem.
This egg,
please.
This egg and womb.
Bear with her.
Bear with her.
Mommy, just to beckon me.
Mommy, testimony and assurance.
Mommy, it's okay now. Let doctor speak.
It's okay.
So sorry. Please.
We are sorry, doctor.
Please.
Proceed.
I'm sorry, baby.
Yes! No, it's just there's so many microbes in the atmosphere. Yes. So you know we cannot be too careful. There could be chlamydia or one of these diseases and bacteria on this table. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. So I'm currently writing my thesis for my PhD right now, and my thesis is on gestational age factors of women in sub-Saharan and Western Africa, and on meeting your beautiful, lovely son, this man right here, he is a perfect test subject. Yes, I have labeled him 0051.
I'm sorry, I'm confused.
Okonidi, don't look at me. It is me that have OND. I don't understand. Ofefomowash experiment ojokumbe.
Oh my, ole malo scientific words.
No
yes,
problem.
Nah, maybe scientific
words. It's okay. Did I tell anything?
Mommy, you're angry.
No,
let her be angry. No, let her be angry. Disgrace herself for the doctor.
You want to disgrace her? Mama, no more sharing of eggs.
Please yes. Keep your egg.
I will keep.
It's even older. It's older and we don't want to egg.
Yes,
ma'am.
What
you said to us was that you were bringing a wife home. What I'm hearing now is text subject, Dr. Francesca
Akanegu.
Akanegu.
Mommies, let me
MD.
Let me talk to her.
MBBS.
Baby.
Yes.
You say 00 something. Is it nickname for me?
Oh.
Because I don't
I'm giving
know.
You uniform. So basically, this thesis I'm working on it's not just me. I have other colleagues who are working on because we're trying to win a Nobel Peace Prize for best in medicine. And this is going to be a once in a lifetime opportunity, especially for us in Nigeria, in Africa. Having him as a test subject, we've had almost 50, that's why he's 0051. So he is going to be the perfect test subject for this. Like recently, last week, I drew some blood. Remember when I took some blood from him? I took some blood from him, you know, to just, you know, fascinated. I wanted to run some DNA, some anatomical tests on him. But next week, me and my colleagues were thinking of, you know, anesthetizing him and just, you know, making some incisions on him.
Which incision are you talking about?
What?
You collected the blood. I thought you want to do tests so that we can be doing skin to skin.
Genotype. That's the only thing I know they do tests for. DAA. This AAS and this, and our son is A.
Yes.
So why are you drawing blood again?
No.
Before you know it, you will open up and start doing what is
what
not.
What is open
up? Hey, have you not been siding with her? But there is no problem.
Leave this thing. Leave this. Leave this one. Leave this.
Or they are going to pay the parents.
So the thing is, we have a non-disclosure policy where doctor-patient confidentiality, we don't disclose the the test results or the test subjects to other people. But not to worry, when this thesis is done and we get this Nobel Prize, we would definitely bring it to both of you for you to bask in the euphoria of your son's achievements. Because it's your son is going to be the perfect test subject for this. Yes.
Do they use your generation?
You
to
have said you will bring the prize.
Yes.
You didn't say anything about bringing our son.
So, once we're done with our testing, because we're going to have to go through an anomaly of tests from bone to skin to blood to brain, every single, yes, we don't want to miss a single thing. Every anatomy of his body is essential to this test. So given that we would carry all these tests out on him, I don't know how to put it.
Anyhow, you have to say it.
Okay. Let me just simplify this.
Yes,
as we come to present the Nobel Peace Prize to you, there is a chance that we would be coming along with the cremated ashes of your son.
You cremated ashes?
Yes, of your son.
Show you auntie cremated.
Don't look at me.
Mommy, do you know what cremated means?
They will burn your child to pieces.
You carried him in your womb for 9 months now.
They will burn your egg to pieces.
No, they will burn you.
Yes,
Ubekumi, you have done well.
No, I did not do well. I did not do well. Me say, I know I did not do well. We came here for marriage purpose. Like, okay, meet my parents.
Madams, mother.
So you want to marry him?
This is Jesse Ubekumi's mom. Don't.
Mommy, stop this fight now.
No, let them talk to your mother. Sit there.
Mommy, don't cremate your son. Don't to cremate your son. You're inviting.
Your mommy is here now.
Abby, you want to kill him? Abby.
And you think we will just sit here? You will bring one Nobel Prize?
Let me just explain. This is a groundbreaking.
Groundbreaking what? Francesca, it's over. It's okay.
What's wrong?
I'm not doing it again, sir. I'm not doing it again.
But madams, you have to understand.
They say it's over, Francesca.
Mommy, she has taken my blood.
Did you ask us before you gave them your blood?
Because I told
you. Did you tell your mother that you're going to give blood?
I was in the relationship already.
Okay. There is no problem. Immediately you entered, then you started saying, your name is Francisca Ikekalagbu, MBA, MSS, SSC, everything that I do not know. You've been telling her, Abby, and she has been responding back to you. There is a problem. Something is wrong with you because I've asked her that did you have, because all these courses go easy for somebody to go and read their PhD, MBD, NSS, and you want to use her son as a sample.
Sorry.
No, don't say anything again. Don't say anything again. Inutin Bimi.
Yes.
Inutin
Bimi. When they are, when mommy is angry.
Hear your mommy.
Let us hear.
What do you have to talk?
Mommy, you are also my mommy. Leave this fight for now.
Let her talk.
What do you have to say, Dr. Francesca?
I'm sorry, but my colleagues are actually outside.
I only have the colleagues here. Hey, just go to me. Ida, lift her. Lift her and throw her, bundle her outside.
Stand up.
Bundle her.
Stand up. Stand up from the...
Ha!
Jesu Ubekumi Nishego.
Yes, Mama.
Testimony and assurance.
Today did not go as planned.
At all. But I believe there's somebody out there for you.
Of course.
Mom, I'm actually trying.
We know.
But I promise tomorrow I will do better. Mm-hmm.
nigga, I'm in my own lane. Already told you silly niggas, we ain't the same. Younger, don't really care if you got more blacks, nigga. Put it on the table, you can take it to the bank. And my love, you know, now it's all about me.